Alfred Nobel was, by every test, one of the great men of his day. But the recognition of his greatness is more universal now than when he died. We know now that he had all the passion and all the vision which the world in his time required and which it still so urgently requires today. Nobel was a chemist. He was a leader in a magical new science, then giving new wonders to the world. Like other scientists and inventors, he discovered without the slightest premonition that it would be so, that the products of his genius could be used in war. The general staff seized eagerly upon his high explosives and used them to increase the firepower and the offensive strength of their armies and their fleets. Watching this rapid and competitive expansion of the military forces which the governments maintain, Nobel sought consolation in the hope that his explosives might prove to be the great deterrent that would end all war. But he had a doubt that many people feel about our modern great deterrent now. He knew he could not be certain that by increasing the slaughter and the devastation caused by war, his explosives would bring armed conflicts to an end. Before most of his generation, he perceived that historically, war was already long out of date, that science and engineering had destroyed the barriers of time and space, that the arms race, by creating distrust and fear, must obscure the people's understanding of where their true national interests lay, that war, if it should come, might imperil or indeed destroy the great achievements in literature, in medicine, in science, which our Western civilization had begun to show. With this magnificent conception of human glory in his mind, he devoted his great fortune to promote the pursuit of knowledge, of beauty, and of wisdom, and to combat what he thought the deadly foolishness of war. What a superb example to others of his generation. How tragic that these others did not follow where he led. Suppose that Krupps and the Hugenberg concern and the Comité des Forges and others had combined with Nobel to use their power to promote the cause of peace. How different might the course of history have been?